Alex Marvez here with my partner, Charles Davis, and we have a reunion of sorts. Former teammates at the NFL Network. Now, Mike Mayock leaving the flock, going to become the Oakland Raiders general manager. And listen, they're better off for it. The media not better off for it because we relied on you for so long because you're one of the nicest people in our industry and taking so much time for folks. And, you know, you're a special guy. So thank you so much again for joining us here on SiriusXM NFL Radio.
Alex, I appreciate it. And while I have the opportunity, what I like to do is just kind of say that Charles Davis is just an amazing dude, and he and I spent a lot of years, man, talking football and getting to know each other's families, and you talk about good people, and I've never met a better person or a better football person.
I'm very lucky to be working with Charles now on SiriusXM NFL Radio. Hopefully that Thursday night slot will be well taken care of for years to come. Mike, you take the plunge. You know, so I ask you this. What can you learn as a general manager now? And you worked as hard as anybody with draft analysts, but what are some of the things that you now learn now that you're behind the curtain, so to speak, working for an NFL team and having access to a lot more information than you did in the past?
Yeah, I think one of my lessons so far has been just the ultimate coordination of a building as opposed to just being ultimately responsible for yourself and your own prep. So it was kind of cool for me for the last 18 years or whatever to sit in a room at home, watch whoever I wanted to watch, as much tape as I wanted to watch, pick the phone up and call a coach or a GM or a scout and say, here's what I'm seeing, what do you see? But ultimately only responsible for that piece of it, really the draft only. You know, my own board and Charles and I would get together and DJ and I would get together, but now you walk into a building and you've got a scouting staff. You know, all of a sudden for the first time in years and years, you're responsible for a group of people. All their integration, all of what they do on a yearly basis. So I think the organization of a group of people is what kind of hit me in the face day one when people are walking into my office and saying, I'm so-and-so from the XYZ department. Are you going to fire me? I mean, I was like, listen, if you want me to fire you, you got to wait at least a week, okay? Because I don't even know what you do yet.
Yeah, but if you ask me a second time, I can do it now.
Whatever you want. But the point is, it's just there's an awful lot of organization necessary, and you're not just responsible for your own draft board.
So, and to take that one step further, look, we've had general managers that change their grading system to accommodate the scouts who are there and then ultimately put in their own system once the draft comes. The timing of your hire was in December. So I ask you, how are you handling that? And how are you also making sure, you know, everyone's on board, all pulling in the right direction when they want to know what Coach Gruden and you are looking for, to build a roster?
It's a really good question. And because of the timing of the hire, as you said, Alex, I went in and met with Sean Herock, our director of college scouting, who's been doing this for a lot of years, you know, first in Green Bay and now here. And I just said to Sean and all the scouts, listen, I'm the new guy, so I'm going to learn your grading system. I've used my own for years, but I'm going to learn yours. We're going to go through the process like you've gone through the process for all these years. And he's a Ron Wolf mentee. So we're kind of doing it the Ron Wolf way. And I just told all the scouts, you know, in May, after we get through free agency in the draft and we take a step back, I'll have had 4 months to evaluate everything. And I'm probably going to make some changes. I'll look at your grading scale, look at mine. We might morph it together. But at the end of the day, whatever changes happen within that building as far as how we do things are going to have to wait till May.
I think what's interesting for me, and you've probably had to tell this story a number of times, Mike, so I don't want to belabor it, but the outside looking in always says, oh, my God, guy comes from the media side.
Yeah.
And now he's a GM of a team. Yeah. How does what I saw, and Alex, I saw this for many years, this man was training to be a GM every day he was doing his job. So it's not like he's just coming from off the pace and we just orbited in and, hey, circles in the whole thing.
Right.
And one of the best compliments I've seen for Mike is when you talk to the scouting community, they feel like one of theirs has ascended to a GM role because of the work Mike did out on the road every year. You go to pro days, you hear people say, he goes more pro days than I go to, and this is my job. This is all those things that go with it. So, Mike, all that being said, as you talk about coordinating a building, you're also at a building that's eager to win now.
Yeah.
Right?
No doubt.
That really wants to win. So has that helped that coordination where people are like, you know something? We've tried it so many different ways. I want to be on the winning side. Are you having people get on board with you that way?
Yeah. And, you know, first of all, what you said is the nicest thing you could say to me is that the scouting community has been open.
I've heard that, Mike. It's not just because we're friends. I've heard that from so many different places. Alex is nodding, so I know he's heard the exact same thing. they feel like this is one of their own who has gone and done this.
See, you got to understand, when I started going to pro days 15 years ago, I was the only guy there, you know, from the media. And they all looked at me like,
what are you doing here?
I was a Martian.
Right.
What are you doing? This is our area. And you had to be really careful early on about what you did and how you did it. And then 3, 4, 5 years later, I'm at the 40-yard dash finish with them with my stopwatch, and I'm one of the guys. And so it's been a process, Charles. And I think as you walk into the building, and are people open to it? I think they have to be open to it. And I think here's the key for me, I think, Charles. There's that elusive word. Culture.
Yes.
Okay. And every new head coach, every new GM uses, hey, we're going to change the culture. Okay.
Yeah.
You know, and that's a word to me that it's really easy to roll off your tongue, but a lot harder to accomplish in the locker room and consistently. So I walk into that building, and John and I have had the conversations like, hey, you know, one playoff in 16 years, you know, that's dysfunctional. Let's be really honest with where we're starting here. And to me, the definition of culture is establishing a high benchmark and staying there every single day, being consistent. And I think that's what we're trying to do. John's doing it on the coaching side. I'm doing it on the scouting side. And I think the best part of our building right now is it's melding together into one. And you guys have been around buildings long enough to know that if the scouting department and the coaching department aren't on the same page, you got no shot.
Raiders general manager Mike Mayock with us here on SiriusXM NFL Radio. Charles and I, as you know, glass half full guys. So I want to ask you, break down the positives of the Oakland Raiders roster at this point of the offseason.
Well, look, we're 4-12 for a reason,
right?
Okay, and you look at our defensive depth chart right now. I mean, we literally have at defensive end Arden Key,
right?
You know, I mean, we basically don't have people under contract. We couldn't even line up today, so we've got an awful lot of holes to fill. And to me, there's both glass half empty and half glass full in that statement. Because on the flip side, the way I look at it as a new GM is, could you imagine walking into a situation as a first-year GM? We have 3 first-round draft picks, 10 overall, some money to spend in free agency, and needs everywhere. So even though needs everywhere means we're a bad football team, to me, what it hopefully means is in free agency we'll be able to fill some of those needs, and we go into that draft and we're just going to draft good football players. I don't have to worry about I have to have this position or we have to have that position. Let's go draft a whole bunch of good football players, because it's going to take us a little time and we've got an awful lot of ammunition over the next couple of years.
How much fun are you having being able to – all right, let's take away the learning the certain aspects of the job where someone comes in and says, hey, Mike, you know, we got a requisition, you know, tissue paper here. Can you sign for this because you're the GM? You, Coach Gruden, the scouts, everyone evaluating prospects, talking ball, breaking down tape. Those conversations, without giving away state secrets, to me have to absolutely be fascinating.
It's the best part of the job, and it's why what I wanted when I took the job and what I hoped it would be when I took the job. And some of the best times have literally been, I was in the building for about a week, and you get there every morning at 5:30 or whatever time, and John's already there. And finally I went over there and I said, John, you know, instead of you watching film over there and me watching film over here, let's watch some film together. And he's like, awesome. And we sat there for 3 hours, 2 of us with the door closed, arguing about football players, talking about scheme, talking about what fits his offense. And I come out of that room going, wow, you know, that's why I'm here. This is all, you know. And you take that and you just – then we go to the All-Star Games and we have the Senior Bowl together, which was just an awesome experience to watch our coaches working with those kids. And we come back from Senior Bowl and we've got both draft meetings going on in one room and free agency meetings going on in another room. I'm hopping back and forth between both of them. And to watch John Gruden, a free agency meeting without a note in front of him, go 3 hours with a planned agenda, player by player by player by player, in front of 25 coaches. And it's mind-numbing how good he is. And his presentation skills and the football conversations, how he challenges his coaches, his scouts, it's awesome, man. And all I know is every day you get in there, you better be ready to go, because John is.